Hello, good morning, sirs. Yesterday we have solved one problem on design of stator current and cross sectional area of stator current. Now, this problem takes you still advanced calculation of bar current, calculation of cross sectional area of rotor bars, and cross sectional of entering current. The given problem is like that. Estimate the main dimensions, air gap length, stator slots, stator turns per phase, and cross sectional area of stator and rotor conductors for a 3 phase 15 HP, 400 volts, 6 pole, 50 hertz, 975 rpm induction motor. The motor is suitable for star delta starting. B average 0.45 Weber per meter square, AC 20,000 amperes conductors per meter. Ratio of length to pole pitch is given 0.85. Efficiency 0.9. Power factor 0.85. So this is given problem. As per the symbolic manner, you write down all given data. All given data before starting the problem. So after that, you start as usual. First, I want to know the output of induction motor. It may be in kilowatt or it may be in HP. Now in this problem, it is HP. First you take the step to convert into kilowatt, that is multiplication of 0.746. Next, directly you go for calculation of KVA input. So Q equal to HP into 0.746 divided by efficiency into power factor. You substitute all the values, then we are going to get around 15.63 kVA. Output coefficient. Output coefficient C naught. C naught equal to 11 times of B average AC into KWS into 10 to the power of minus 3. You go on substituting values. If stator winding factor is not given, you assume usual value 0.955 or 0.96. No problem. So then output coefficient, we are going to get around 94.5. Next, go for synchronous speed. Synchronous speed, NS equal to 2F by P. So this value you are going to get around 16.66 revolutions per second. Already we are knowing, after calculation of all these three steps, go for output equation, Q equal to C naught d square L ns. From this equation, we have to calculate d square L. So d square L equal to Q divided by C naught into ns. This value 9.28 into 10 to the power of minus 3, you call the equation number 1. So dear students, all of you solve one or two problem to get the same answer. After that you go for unsolved problem. What is the given condition? Ratio of length to pole pitch equal to 0.85 is given. It is given in problem. Ratio of length to pole pitch. Pole pitch means tau. Tau equal to pi d by p. So that is L by tau equal to 0.85. So tau equal to pi d by p. You substitute the value, then we are going to get as L equal to 0.44 times of D. Call the equation number 2. Then substituting this L value in equation 1, from equation 1 and 2, we are going to get D equal to 0.75 or 0.28 meters, L equal to 0.12 meters. Put the block. This finishes 50% of the problem. After that, by knowing the specific magnetic loading, using that equation, go for the calculation of flux per pole. That is pi m equal to B average, pi dl divided by p, where p is the number of poles, d is the diameter, it is in meter, l is the length, it is also in meter. Substitute, we are going to get 7.77 the power of minus 3 Webers. So we have to design the induction motor for star delta starter. Hence, we have to design the stator winding for delta. Hence, by knowing the equation for the stator phase voltage, from that expression, it is possible to calculate stator turns per phase. What is the value of ES? Which type of connection the stator winding has? It is delta, star delta starting, means we have to design the stator winding in delta. Hence, line voltage equal to phase voltage, ES equal to 400 volts. So, you calculate the TS. TS, we are going to get around 242. Once we are knowing the TS, then it becomes very easy to calculate total stator conductors. Total stator conductors equal to 6 times of TS. Next, we have to go for selection of stator slots. What is the first condition? Stator slot pitch should lies between 15 mm to 25 mm. Then you take the values YSS equal to 15 mm, calculate SS 58. When YSS equal to 25 mm, calculate SS, it becomes 34. It gives the idea the stator slots lies in the range of 58 to 34 or 34 to 58. This is first condition. What is the second condition? The stator slots should satisfy a multiple value of Q. Q should be number of slots per pole per phase. So, ultimately, we have to go for calculation of stator slots for different values of Q. When Q equal to 2, calculate the number of stator slots. Stator slots equal to M, P, Q. So, respective values, we are going to get 36, 54, 72. What is the final selection? Final selection is 36. So, calculate the ZSS. So, total stator conductors equal to SS into ZSS. It is around 1440. So, new value of TS, we are going to get around 240. Then, we know that KVA input Q equal to 3 times of EP IP into 10 to the power of minus 3. Then, you calculate the phase current, that is stator current. So, IP equal to Q into 10 to the power of 3 convert into volt ampere divided by 3 into EP. EP, that is phase voltage. Phase voltage, in previous problem we used it may be EL. So, don't confuse. You remember general expression. This is general expression. Q equal to 3 times EP IP into 10 to the power of minus 3. Either we can use root 3 EL IL into 10 to the power of minus 3. You can use any one. Okay. So, IP equal to 12.18 ampere. That is stator current for phase. Once we are knowing the stator current, then I can assume current density. Then it is possible to calculate cross-sectional area of stator conductor, respective current density. So, current density is in amperes per millimeter square. Therefore, cross-sectional area of stator conductor 4.061, that also in millimeter square. Length of air gap LG equal to 0.2 plus 2 under square root of D and DL. So, LG is usually small as compared to D and DL. Therefore, we have to substitute D and DL are in meters, but LG should be in millimeter. One of the empirical relation for small rating motors. You substitute, we are going to get as 0.56 mm. After that, selection of rotor slots, it is also big important. So, let us assume SR be the number of rotor slots, SS be the number of stator slots. There are certain conditions the selection of rotor slots should satisfy. So by keeping all the things, the rules have been made, SS minus SR cannot be equal to 0, cannot be equal to plus or minus P, plus or minus 2P, plus or minus 3P, plus or minus 5P, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus into bracket P plus or minus 1, or P plus or minus 2. You write down the number of poles, go on substituting the values, 1 plus 1 for minus. We are going to get this one. SS minus SR may not be equal to 0, plus or minus 6, plus or minus 12, plus or minus 18, plus or minus 30, and so on. So we have to select the number which should not lie in this range. Hence, plus or minus 3 is not available here. Hence, I have to take SS minus SR may be equal to plus 3 or may be equal to minus 3. Getting the idea? Either you can use plus value, either you can use minus value. So, SR should be equal to SS minus 3. So, I am keeping that SR selection should be less than stator slots. Hence, it becomes 33. Final selection of rotor slots is 33. So, we are knowing the equation rotor bar current IB equal to 0.85 times 6 times of ISTS divided by SR. You substitute the value directly, we are getting bar current. Bar current equal to 451 amperes. Then you assume current density respective same 3 to 5 ampere per millimeter square. Now you can assume 4 amperes per millimeter square in rotor bar. Then it is possible to design cross sectional area of rotor bar equal to rotor current density. So, we are going to get around 113 millimeter square. In same fashion, we have to calculate end ring current. End ring current equal to SR into IB divided by pi P, where SR is rotor slots. You substitute the value, we are going to get around 791 amperes. Then you assume the current density same as 4 amperes per millimeter square in end ring. Hence, it is possible to calculate cross-sectional area of end ring. Cross-sectional area of end ring equal to end ring current and current density in end ring. This we are going to get around 197.77 meter square. So, in examination, any half part should be asked. This problem is very important. Actually, this problem consists two parts, either stator side and rotor side. You practice this problem very thoroughly. Getting the idea? Okay. Thank you, sirs and madams, to all.